must have seen this setting in your house. You press the switch and the bulb starts glowing. Have you ever thought about what happens behind the wall that causes the bulb to glow? You must have heard from elders in your house or teachers in school that the glowing of a bulb is based on electric current. But what is electric current? Where it is made from? And how does this help in glowing the bulb? In today's video, we'll get to know what the electric current is and how it flows from one place to another. You must have seen a moving car. Some cars move fast and some slow. We also say that the car is moving at a speed of 40 km per hour. But what is this 40 km per hour? Meaning the car is covering a distance of 40 km in 1 hour. So when we compare anything with time, they are called the rate of that thing. Like the speed of the car, we can see the flow of water in the river in the same way and say that the water current is more. Similarly, the case with the air current as well. So it would be fair to say that current is a physical quantity which shows a relation of different parameters with time. If everything that flows has current, what will they call the current that glows the bulb when you put on the switch? We call it electric current. The rate of flow of electric charge is called electric current. If Q is the electric charge passing through a particular area in time t, then the ratio of Q and t represents electric current, which can be represented as I. The SI unit of electric current is ampere, whose symbol is A. The electric charge flows from one point to another through metallic wires. In the circuits having metallic wires, electrons create the flow of charge. The circuit should be closed from one end to another to let the charge flow. This closed path is called an electric circuit. This diagram shows a circuit in which the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the positive terminal of the bulb via wires through a switch, and the negative terminal of the battery is connected to the negative terminal of the bulb. Great, we understood the circuit. But what does this positive and negative mean? These positive and negative signs indicate the direction of current in the circuit. The electric current starts flowing from the positive terminal of the battery and ends at the negative terminal. It is also to be noted that electrons move in the opposite direction of the current. But we also know that electrons are responsible for the flow of charge and the electric current depends on the charge. Then why the electric current moves in the opposite direction? Due to the flow of electrons, a positive charge is generated in the metallic wires. The direction of this charge, which appeared to be in the opposite direction of the electrons, here the direction of the electric current is taken towards the direction of this positive charge, which is formed for no other reason but due to the flow of electrons. Just as the speedometer is used to measure the speed of the vehicle, similarly in any circuit, an instrument named ammeter is used to measure the electric current. Do you know a similar type of circuit is present in our homes too? But here, the positive and the negative wires are not connected to the battery, but are connected to the power supply coming into the house. We'll know more closely about this in the upcoming videos.